Everybody, it's Invicta. It's time for another Solo Queue Silius here on Super Sunday. And I figured, what better way to celebrate real sports with esports? And by esports, I mean, of course, the Mayhem Begins event. And by the Mayhem Begins event, I mean playing as Murky, the character that literally no one expected me to play, including myself. The character that I thought Jesse was going to be playing, and then at the last minute we decided to change it up because the other team was expecting me to play Illidan, and they instantly banned Illidan, which moved me to Jaina, and then I decided not to play Jaina because my Jaina's terrible. And then Jesse was like, hey, you should just play Murky, and I'm like, okay. Yeah, so everyone knows how that goes. So what I'm going to be doing today is a little bit of a different variation because I've been playing against Murky players for the past couple of days. I don't want to say weeks because I haven't been playing that long. But I have been noticing that March of the Murlocs, man, is freaking scary. Like, super duper ultra scary. And I wanted to try out the build with Murky that allows me to do a March of the Murlocs build, but also allows me to have a little bit of the Mayhem Begins build that I had, which is going to involve Bubble Breeze, level 4 here. I'll still be going for the Bigger Slime, level 7, still going to be going for Compressed Air. That's not going to change. Although Hindering Slime does kind of... I will admit, Hindering Slime does seem to make a little bit more sense now that I think about it, especially because of the fact that I am planning on doing the March of the Murlocs. So we might go Hindering Slime, and then level 10, March of the Murlocs, level 13, I'll be going, I don't know, probably Continuous Slime. And then after that, probably going to go Slimy. I may do Slimy Perfect, I may do Blood for Blood, and of course we'll also still be going with Rewind here at level 20. So, but let's not get ahead of ourselves. It's been a while since I played as Murky. Apparently we're going up against Abathur on our team today, by the way. It's going to be Artanis, Murky, Kerrigan, Sylvanas, who are in a party, I believe, and Zul'jin going up against Valyra, Jaina, Vala, Abathur, and Dahaka, who are in a party as well. Apparently there's just a whole lot of death going on down there. Me and Abathur, we're sort of just chilling up top. But March of the Murlocs, like, I was getting destroyed by March of the Murlocs when me and Jesse were playing. I was playing as Tassadar. Not Tassadar, I was playing as Valyra. And I kept running into Murky players doing March of the Murlocs, and I'm like, why? To my recollection, March of the Murlocs is not, like, all that great. But then again, it's been a long time since I've gone March of the Murlocs, so I don't know. And, yeah, it turns out the stacking damage that the Murlocs do is pretty darn good. And I just decided, you know what? I want to try it. With it being Super Sunday, you're not watching football. You're not doing anything else today, man or woman. So why not watch some Solo Queue Silius here, and then go watch the Super Bowl? If you're not watching the Super Bowl today, good for you. You know, good for you. Way to be the outliers of today, because I'm probably, at the time of this recording, I'm not watching the Super Bowl, but at the time of this going up, I'm probably getting ready to watch the Super Bowl. And no, I don't have any sort of, I don't have any bias as far as what teams are going in and which teams are going to win or not. I don't honestly care. I mean, it's a weird, for me, it's like a weird, it's a little bit of a weird happenstance because I'm a Tampa Bay Buccaneers fan, as everyone knows, and as everyone knows, the Tampa Bay Buccaneers are terrible, but the reason why I bring them up is because the Bucs are actually in the Falcons division, the NFC South, and so you get this sort of weird, you sort of get this weird mentality of like, well, They're not my team, but I kind of want them to win just so I can say, hey, we've got, you know, a Super Bowl winner in the NFC South at least. Like, I don't like the Falcons at all, but I also don't like the Patriots all that much. Although my mom is a Patriots fan. I don't know what Valyra's. Oh, Valyra actually was able to get the pufferfish down, which is surprising. Valyra is right behind the. She's right there next to the locust. I'm not sure if you can see that. Like I said, sometimes the shimmer shows up and sometimes it doesn't. I am going to go back down there, though, to help out my team. Again, I did take the larger slime, the bigger slime radius, which is going to allow me to land my slow a little bit more frequently. Artanis going after Valyra here. I am going to go ahead and pop the slime as well. I want to use the safety bubble so I can try to body block and land the slow on Vala. Down she goes. Jaina is actually staying on top of the puffer. She's going to get taken out as well. Sorry, Kerrigan, I couldn't help you, but we got the kill on Jaina and on Vala. Which is just hilarious. I'm going to head back up top because there's really nothing I can do, although there is a there's another camp over here that I guess I could take. Never mind, just kidding. Valyra getting upset that I killed two of her teammates down there. That's okay. We'll go ahead and wait for everyone else to get back, and then we'll keep on going. But yeah, I'm not a Patriots fan. I'm not a Falcons fan. I've never really been a Falcons fan. Always been a Bucks fan. And the Bucks aren't going to make it to the Super Bowl in the next probably 3 or 4 years, I would say. So I'm not holding my breath for that. There's a whole lot of death going on right now. So I am going to go for Hindering Slime just for the S's and G's. I want to see how hilarious it can be. I'm going to see if I can body block. Yeah, good job by Sylvanas. Taking down Vala. She was not able to reliably get away from the Hindering Slime. I'm going to go ahead and grab this Watchtower as well. And again, Hindering Slime is going to increase the slow amount of my Q ability up to 30% now instead of 20. And that is not an insignificant amount of slow, especially when you consider how many non-mobile heroes the enemy team has on their team. Outside of pretty much Dahaka and Vala. And I guess Abathur, but he's not really a mobile hero, you know what I mean. Speaking of mobile heroes, I've been having a lot of fun playing Fire Emblem Heroes. I'm a sucker for gacha games, that's all I can really say. Like, if you, like, a game like, Summoner's War is probably the game that I spent the most money on of all time. I enjoyed Summoner's War. Chaos Chronicle was a lot of fun. Those kind of games. I love free-to-play games. I've always been a fan of them. If Blizzard did a gacha game, I'm sure it would be awesome. And no, Hearthstone doesn't count. Hearthstone doesn't count as a real game. No, I won't say that. I won't say that. Just because you don't like a game, Sinvicta, doesn't mean that other people aren't enjoying themselves. I know. Dahaka. I'm not sure if Dahaka realizes the danger that he's in. Because I could easily catch up to him and land the slow here. And remember, with the combined movement speed buff that I get from using Safety Bubble, that allows me to close the gaps very, very easily. We're actually able to take down the bottom four, it looks like. And we're just going to keep on going. Level 10 here. Going to go for March of the Murlocs. I get grabbed by Dahaka, but who really cares? It's Murky. You could make an argument that I should have used March of the Murlocs there. I'm going to come over here and see if I can help out Sylvanas take down Dahaka. And there is Valera, actually. I am going to go ahead and activate March of the Murlocs here just because I do want to get a lot of damage on the fort. If we can actually get this fort down this turn, that'd be awesome. Because that'd be two forts down for the enemy team. I don't actually know where Abathur is. I can see Artanis is now going after Valera. I'm going to use the Safety Bubble, see if I can catch up to Valera. We can land the Primal Grab. Go into Hindering Slime, which was able to slow her down enough. We might be able to get her. No, she was just able to get away. If only Artanis had enough mana to use Blade Dash, he could have definitely caught up to Valera. I see that Dahaka is over here. Dude, there's been like a lot of fighting going on in this match. 14 to 7, 21 deaths at 7 minutes is pretty incredible. That's incredible. I know they're all. Couldn't get Safety Bubble off in time, unfortunately. But again, as Murky, you don't really care about dying. You understand that you're going to die a lot. There's Wailing Arrow by Sylvanas. I'm going to see if I can get... I was able to get the slime there on Valera. Unfortunately, though, Artanis did miss with the Prism. So the enemy team coming up here and going to try to make a play on it. I was able to see Valera right at the end there. She popped Smoke Bomb. I'm going to see if I can toss down a Pufferfish in between. Pufferfish right on top of Dahaka. I did land the Pufferfish on him. Unfortunately, I don't have March of the Murlocs up quite yet. But if I get down there in time to use March of the Murlocs, the enemy team's going to be in a lot of trouble. Jaina now coming on in with a blizzard. Gonna go tap the fountain real quick. Never mind, just kidding. This Jaina's super upset. She overextended for a Murky kill, and now she's gonna get herself killed for it, which is the greatest justice of all time. I'm not going to go down that this time around. I am gonna activate my March of the Murlocs here on this fort if I have to. Now, obviously, with Murky, you have to be careful of where you're. Egg is placed. Also, we have this camp coming up here as well. So I'm going to go ahead and activate March of the Murlocs here. We can take down this fort if possible. Man, my reflexes are off on the safety bubble today. I feel like I'm half second behind. But I'm helping out the Siege Giants right now. I do see Abathur. Jaina was forced to come up here as well. I wasn't able to eat most of the toxic nests there. The enemy team does have 65, and I do see that Dahaka is over here as well. Hello, Dahaka. Dahaka. Dahaka on the mic. And you see the hindering slime is so scary. You don't want to get caught in it with Murky, I'm telling you. So I'm going to go with continuous slime. This is going to decrease the cost, or the cooldown rather, of a slime from 4 seconds to 3 seconds. And again, Murky does not have any mana, so you can basically spam this over and over again. And I was able to get the slime there on Jaina, and I'm just going to keep on slowing her. Who really cares if we can get a kill on Jaina? There you go, we've got her trapped, and she's going to end up getting killed. Again, who cares if Murky dies? You want to set your team up for the kill, and that's exactly what Murky's good at. So here we go, we're going to try to push for that golem up top. The enemy team has no way of stopping their fort from going down up here. And this is going to be a very, very nasty push here. My March of the Murlocs will be up here momentarily. There we go. So if I wanted to play super aggressive, I could try to put my egg up here in the bushes. It's usually not a good idea to do that unless you're in constant contact with your team. It's a little bit safer to do on this composition because I do have a Sylvanas. Here we go. I'm going to call the Murlocs over here. Unfortunately, we don't have the rest of our team to help out. There was a Taz Dingo there by Zul'jin. I was able to land the slow there on Jaina as well. As long as we keep getting the pufferfish damage off, that's all we really need to do. Our team now is taking down the rest of their golem. And we got their keep almost dead, which is a heck of a push. Really good job by our team. So here are 10 and a half minutes, 18 to 11. And again, 62,000 siege damage. Really have not done a whole lot of fighting as far as the actual team fighting goes. See if I can catch up to Jaina. Unfortunately, though, I'm not going to be able to catch her. I did catch her, but I'm not going to be able to kill her, unfortunately. Unless she doesn't see the pufferfish. You see how strong that slow is, though. You got to be careful with Murky. If he slows you, you're going to be in trouble. Again, Murky is there to set up kills. You're not really going to be brawling with this build, but you will be doing a lot of setups. Murky can deal damage, don't get me wrong. Murky can deal lethal damage if he has to. This Valyria player is super duper salty. Nice swap there by Artanis. And there's Valyria. I'm going to go ahead and wait for the Blizzard to fall. Never mind, she went for the Tri-Blizzard build, which is a lot of fun. I'm looking for the Shimmer of Valyria. You know she's around here somewhere. Help out Artanis here. The mine should be coming up pretty soon, so very, very close game so far. There you go. Unfortunately, I was not able to get to Kerrigan in time. So you got to be careful with Valyria stalking around everywhere. Level 16, going to be going for, probably be going for Blood for Blood, to be honest. I like having the burst damage and a little bit of a heal coming in from my active item as well. So there's Taz Dingo. I'm going to go ahead and use March of the Murlocs here. And Dahaka doesn't really, well, Dahaka actually is going to be able to get away from most of that. Use Blood for Blood on him to try to get a little bit more damage done. But unfortunately, Artanis is going to fall. And I'm not going to be able to stop it either. So now my egg is in a little bit of trouble. They do know where my egg is. I don't know what Dahaka was doing, but Dahaka getting caught out. Again, that triple blizzard is not a build that you see all that often. But who really knows in solo queue? So the mines are coming up here. I am going to have to move my egg. I do see that nest here by Abathur. I'm going to go ahead and take care of that because Lord only knows when that's going to hurt somebody. March of the Murlocs down for another 49 seconds. There's the Haka. Unfortunately, I was not able to get the slime off on the Haka. Nice leap there by Kerrigan. Power play in favor of our team right now. And that's a big loss there for the enemy team. I do see Valyria right there. I did use Blood for Blood on her as well. She's going to get taken out. Trying to catch up to Vala. If I can hit the hindering slime on her, which I was able to do. We set her up, take her down. Sylvanas did get killed by, I believe that was Vala's Strafe. But we were able to take down three of them. And again, you see so much the potential of Murky. You have to stay away from Murky. If he hits you with the slime, I'm telling you, it's over. As long as your teammates are near. even Janna gets taken down here. I'm going to go ahead and try to push down this final keep. I do have March of the Murlocs back up. And that's the freedom that you get with Murky. It doesn't really matter if you die as long as you're able to set up more kills than you give up. Easy peasy. Again, Murky only counts for a quarter of what the of what an enemy team hero counts for. I use March of the Murlocs there on Valera. She ends up having to use Vanish. You see how much damage the Murlocs are doing? She's got five Murlocs on her. And she's lucky that she was able to get that stun off in between my my safety bubbles. Man, safety bubble is like really not responding as fast as I would like. We have died a whole lot, but that's okay because we've also set up a whole lot. I did land the pufferfish on the monstrosity. Unfortunately, I was not able to get out of there. I should be able to get out before the egg dies. One more. Yes, I was able to just barely get out of there. The enemy has literally could not have been any closer. So I do have to wait on my egg placement here. The enemy team, when Murky does have the exclamation point, the enemy team can see you, by the way. I just want to make them think that I was going to place it out there, but I'm actually going to be a little bit more conservative with this placement. If I get an opportunity to place it a little bit further forward, though, I will. Now, one of the opportunities that you can do, one of the variations of Murky that you can do, is you can go for Bribe at level 1, which is not a bad build for a Haunted Mines. It's not really a good two-lane map, however, build. In my opinion, anyway. I mean, like, Haunted Mines would probably be the only two-lane map that I would say try Bribe with Murky. But that's just more of my playstyle. You'll see a lot of Murky players, they automatically default to taking Bribe at level 1, no matter what the map is. Because Bribe is so good, especially considering that it does reset the spawn timers a lot sooner, which is something, that's a new mechanic I actually did not know about until very recently. I'm not going to use March of the Murlocs here on the Grave Golem. We don't really need it. They're not going to break through the wall here, and our Grave Golem is still doing work on the enemy team's bottom keep. And once I get back to the top lane, I should be able to take down their top keep, no problem. Level 20 here. Oh, you know what? Let's go for Neverending Murlocs. Why not? Why not? I don't normally do March of the Murloc builds. For those of you who might be newer to the channel or newer to see me play Murky, my usual build is an Octograb build. And then I take Rewind at level 20. And then I can just continually stunlock the enemy team over and over again. It's great. That's also the build that I played at Mayhem Begins. You can go, instead of Hindering Slime for this build, if you want to try a variation, instead of Hindering Slime, you can go for Compressed Air, which increases the radius of your W, which is also very, very dangerous for the enemy team, because if they get caught by that, that's pretty much it for them. Look how mad this Valera player is. Get your licks in now, Valera. She knows as soon as I'm alive. The only way to catch Murky is off guard, and I actually saw her there as well. Nice job by our team taking out two. So basically, Valera overextended Janna and Vala to get me, and then my team came to my rescue. Thank you, team. You know that Valera is going to be hunting for my egg. I heard the Vanish go off somewhere. I actually thought that Valera was right in front of me, but apparently not. Doesn't really matter, though, because while Valera was trying all that shenanigan funny business here, we are taking over their base. There's Valera. I'm looking for the blood for blood execute on her. I will throw the pufferfish a little bit more aggressively. She is right there behind the Haka. I did get Hearing Slime, activated blood for blood as well. I might be on a body blocker, but we don't have any more damage, unfortunately, on her. I'm going to drop a pufferfish here. Unfortunately, I did not get it off nearly in time. Apparently Artanis and Kerrigan wanted us to know where the core is. So we end up getting the win there. Final total 28-22. I didn't really do a whole lot of fighting as far as team fighting goes, but you see how much fun it is to set up your team for kills, even if it is solo queue. So check it out. I'll leave the build down below. Thank you for watching. Enjoy the Super Bowl, everyone and anyone. And as always, I'll see you all in the next episode. Until then, so long, everybody!